later. So first thing we do is to click File, New File, and create a R script. So for example, I can create a R script here. And there are two ways. I mainly want to introduce two ways to create a R dataset. So let me type it here. Two ways to import, two ways to prepare a dataset in R. And the first way we are going to talk about is just to type the variables and the data in. So to do that, I need to define my variables and I need to put the values in. So for example, I can set x equals 1 to 10. So if I do this and I run it, then x will be defined as a variable which only takes values from 1 to 10. So that 1 and 10 means 1, 2, 3, 4 until 10. And I can define another variable y, which may take several values randomly. So let me make y has the length 10 as well. And I'm going to type the values as 2, 3, 5, maybe 8, 10, 12, 13, 16, and 18. How many values I have here? 5, 9, 10. So let me type the last value as 20. So if you define a few values, more than one value, then you need to type the C and type the parentheses and put the values in. So in this way, I am actually creating two variables. But when you have a dataset, right? When you have a dataset, when you want to create a dataset, when you want to build models, you may want to prepare a data table. So in that way, I'm going to define data equals data.frame. So this is a function for creating a data frame. So I can let it to be x and y. In that way, my data is prepared. So I have run x. I need to run the line 6, which is a variable y. And then I need to run the data line. So in that way, the data is actually prepared. And you can view the data using the view function with capital V. So if I view the data, you can see x variable is the first variable, y is the second, and both of them have 10 values. And then you can do analysis, right? You can actually check the names of the data, which will be the variable names you have, x and y. And you can define, you can also draw a plot of it. Like if I draw a plot of x and y, I can just do plot x comma y, and then I can get a plot on the right corner. So you can see the plot. You can also zoom it to see the bigger picture here. And so you can see it is linearly related. From x and y, they are actually linearly related. So I want to build a linear model, which is y followed by x. And then you don't need to specify data equals data because your x and y actually are defined before the data was created. So you can just use lmy with x. And then I'm going to define it as my model 1. So I can run that line. And then I want to add the fitted model line into my scatter plot because I want to see how would a line, a straight line like this, would fit my data points. So appline is a function to add the fitted line to the model. And then if you write, you can see a line was added to the dots. And that line describes very well of the general pattern between X and Y. So let me type some note here. So define the variables. So these are defining the variables. And this is create a data frame. And this one is for check the data set. And this, the names function is to check the variables in the data. And this is for creating a scatter plot. And this is for fit a simple linear regression model. And the last one here is to add the fitted model line into the scatter plot. So this is, I am going a little bit far, but so after I created the data set, I was like non-stop. I fit a model, I draw a plot, I fit the model, and I add the model line to the plot. But that is like a quick overview of how you are going to create a data set from scratch and then do some basic analysis with it. The second way to use a data set is to import it. Import a data set from other sources. For example, it can be .csv file, or it can be Excel file. It can even be SAS or SPSS files, but most of the time you're going to see people are making datasets available in either CSV or Excel data file. So I'm going to show you an example how to import a dataset from .csv. So you click File, and then click Import Dataset. So if you're importing a dataset from CSV, you can actually click either one on the top. If you are importing a dataset from Excel, then you should click Choose from Excel. So if you have another kind, just check the corresponding kind of options here. So now I'm going to import a dataset from TextBase. And the data I'm going to look for is in my downloads folder, and I'm going to click the BERS dataset. So that BERS dataset, you can see you get an overview here in the data frame. So you actually have the number of visits, and you also have future behavior. Those are the two variables in the BERS dataset. So the code is even typed out for you. I often copy the code to the R script, because next time you can just run this line, and then you can run the following code you are going to type. Otherwise, if you just refer it a BERS dataset, next time when you open your R script, R will not remember what the BERS is. So I copy the code there, and you can also do similar things like check what variable names you have, and you can also check the first six lines of the data you have. So without viewing the whole data set, you can just check the first six lines of the data. And I can also create a plot like I did for the X and Y variable. So I can use plot. This time I need to refer back to the data set because I need to specify what my variable is coming from, where my variables are coming from. So I can draw a plot, and I can even fit a model. Let's call it model 2. And this time I can do it in two ways. So I can use Sorry, I can copy future behavior here as my response variable and the number of visits as my predictor. And then I can set the data equals birth. So in that way, those variables will be referred back to the data set. So we are talking about the variables specifically. So I can fit a model like this. I can also add this model line into my scatter plot here. And there is another way to fit the model, which is similar to the plus function. But I'm going to use the data set with the dollar sign and then the variable name, which is my, this is my response variable, and this is my predictor, because I have referred to the data set name when I talked about the, when I typed the variable names. So I don't need to type data equals to. So R new, it will be from the birds data set. So you are going to get the same results for both of them. Let me name it model 3. And you can even run model 2 and model 3 and see we are getting the same results. Oh, I need to run model 3 first, and then I run model 3 by itself. So you are going to see the intercept, the slope, they are actually doing the same thing. So this is import a data set from CSV, and this is for check variables in the data set. And this is for check the first 6 rows of data, and this is the scatter plot. And this is fit the simple linear regression model. And that is add a regression line. And I'm also going to make a note that model 2 and model 3 are the same. They are doing exactly the same thing. I hope this video is helpful.